Dirty Pretty Things there with Bang Bang You're Dead. Before that, you heard the Fratellis. They're so hot right now with Chelsea Dagger. It's a song so amazingly enjoyable and good that you think they couldn't possibly be good like that for the rest of their career, could they? That was Joe Cornish. This is Adam Buxton. Joe's very excited. Was that a grunt of extreme pleasure?
No, that's just a grunt of waking up. Hello, listeners. Listen, there's something extraordinary happening in the next door studio. Like, genuinely, I don't know whether Marsh has already told people who've been listening, but one of the modern masters of modern music is in there. The frightening thing is, though, I think we might be being heard all around the studio.
It's possible.
So can they hear us?
I don't think so, because they're doing a session in there.
Right,
but you've got to tell people who it is.
Duncan from Blue. Duncan from Blue is in the next door studio.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he's the sexy one, in case you don't know about Blue.
He's looking very sort of mean.
He's dressed head to foot in black.
In black.
Yeah. Black jeans, a black shirt open to between the nip-nips. And he's just very sexy. He's slightly stubbly. And he's got blonde highlights in his hair. And I've been watching him sing.
Right.
And when you can't actually hear the noise, which obviously is beautiful, it's amazing just to see what he does with his hands. Emoting, clasping his heart.
No.
Pointing.
Just on looking a session.
You know how boy band singers look bashful and look down and look up again?
Yeah.
He's been doing that even on a session.
That's extraordinary. And he's in there with a really cool-looking, could I say, posse?
You could say posse.
And they've got acoustic guitars.
Yeah.
You know, so it's real. This is from the heart, what they're doing.
And when he finished doing that song, he gave the mixer two thumbs up.
Yeah.
And slapped everyone on the shoulder.
Double thumbs. We might be watching a slice of music history.
Yeah.
From the next room, because we've got a great big window through to the session room from our studio.
I know. In the future, when someone writes Duncan from Blue's biography,
mm-hmm.
right, they might interview us about what we saw.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's like watching Marvin Gaye or Kurt Cobain.
Yeah, or the Cheeky Girls.
A couple of differences.
Or Last Ketchup.
It's like watching Last Ketchup.
You know.
That's it's too exciting. So listen, we're going to watch a bit more, listeners, and bring you the latest Duncan from Blue news, because we know XFM listeners are crazy about Blue and, you know, really need to know exactly what Duncan's up to.
And we'll tell you more about what you can expect from this week's show after this one from McAlmont and Butler.
Come on, keep moving. Keep moving along. Nothing to see here. Keep moving. Come on.
It's a Rush Hour song.
So I've heard some of Duncan's lyrics. I went next door and pushed open the door. If you've just tuned in, Duncan from Blue is doing a session next door to us. It's incredibly
sure
exciting.
Can't hear what we're saying, because he might just come in.
I just stepped outside and checked that the radios are off.
Okay.
He wouldn't lamp us.
Are you sure?
Yeah, Duncan understands that if you're in a room next door to us, we cannot resist taking the mickey.
Yeah.
It's scientifically impossible not to. He's rhymed street with feet.
That's fair enough.
He's rhymed park with spark.
I like that.
Yeah, and he's rhymed terrapin with leadening.
Has he?
Yeah.
He's like Sid Barrett.
At the end he is. It goes a bit weird at the end of his song.
The terrapin thing isn't real.
That's not true, no. Okay. But actually, Duncan's left, and now his session musicians are all sitting round, probably struggling to make something out of what he's sung.
To deal with,
he just probably came in and just went,
just improvise some stuff.
I'm in the park. Our love is the spark. Ooh. All right, that's it. Do what you can with it. I'll see you next week. Bye. Okay. Oh God. Ding, 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 ding. In the park. Ding, ding. That's how they all sound, don't they?
That's the hit formula.
Who's the other one that's successful from Blue?
You know what? You're talking to the wrong man for Blue Facts.
The black guy. What's he called? Lee.
Roger.
No, Lee's the one with the high voice.
Gimpo.
I don't know. I thought they'd all been put down by the government, but no. I mean, just insulted by a politician.
So this week, listeners, what an exciting show we have for you.
Yes.
Because not only do we have another round of our new competition, Rock and Reel, or Rock and Rubs, which I think we'll play later on this hour.
It was a smash last week.
Absolute smash. I've been reading letters all this week from people.
Yeah, you were being stopped in the street, weren't you?
I was being stopped
in the
street. By crowds
chanting, Rock and Rubs, Rock and Reel.
Yeah.
Is that true?
That is true. A couple of bands opened up their set with a version of
people
the song.
People are going crazy. There's T-shirts already.
T-shirts, internet phenomena.
It's
there's
the
a
most
website.
Successful local radio competition.
With 5 million hits a day, the website's
getting. 5 million
hits. Our podcast shot straight to number one.
Number one.
For an hour, and then it went back down again.
To 12.
To 12. But for that moment, it was an absolute sensation. Anyway, we're going to be playing that competition. Just a reminder that all you have to do is guess which bands are real and which ones are rubs out of a list of 10. We'll do that in about 20 minutes.
Yeah, the phone number 0871-222-1049, 0871-222-1049 for any competition entries. You can text us on 83XFM. And as prizes, we've got Tartan Asia Extreme horror movies. There's one with a man with a sort of, I don't know, a bumpy face. it's not called Bumpy Face
Can
Man,
I see?
But it should be.
What's happened
It's called
to
Premonition.
His face?
Bumpy Faith Man. And there's another one called Another Public Enemy with a couple of sexy, stylish Korean gentlemen on the front.
Premonition, he's just got a piece of paper and wet it and scrunched it onto his head.
He's got damp toilet roll.
Yeah, why doesn't he just wipe it off? That would solve his problem.
It. Plus, we've got Nighty Night Series 2.
Hey, that's a good prize.
Is that the good series, though?
They're both good. They're all good.
They're all good. How many series?
99. Well, there's only two so far.
Two, yeah.
I think I don't know if she's doing a third. But series two was fairly extreme. That was the one that really
it's quite hardcore.
Yeah.
So good prizes plus tickets to see Placebo on the 9th of December. That's a good prize. One pair of tickets to see Placebo, very in demand tickets, and a pair of tickets to see DJ Shadow at the Brixton Academy. That'll
DJ
be fantastic.
Shadow. You can't see me because I'm a shadow. Shadow. Shadow.
That's what he's like.
There he is.
DJ Shadow, next I'm going to play something that you can't even hear, because it's just an echo, echo, echo.
Ah, it doesn't sound like a very good gig.
It's not a very good gig the way I'm doing it, but he does it much better. Also, I'm going to be reviewing something I haven't seen yet. That's an old feature that we used to do years ago.
Right.
That I'm bringing back. Might do that fairly shortly. Review for something I haven't seen yet. And also, I'm going to be unveiling a phone call that I made to McVitie's, to the Jaffa Cake.
Oh, this is exciting stuff, yeah.
Because Joe and I are, would you say obsessed? Not obsessed.
We're obsessed with Jaffa's Cakes, and we're obsessed with the fact that Jaffa Cakes say on the side that they're recommended by sports nutritionists. If you're in the shops today, check out Jaffa Cakes. There's a panel on the side. It says recommended by sports nutritionists.
Not only that, but it says on the bottom of the packet, in fairly small writing, Jaffaholics Anonymous, if you have a problem, call in the strictest confidence this number. And then it gives you a couple of numbers underneath. And so I called the number. And you'll hear what happened later on.
A bit
in
later.
The show.
It's so exciting. So stay tuned.
Stay tuned, absolutely. Here's a free play right now, the first of our free plays this week. This is Ween. This is from their album White Pepper. And it's called Exactly Where I'm At. This is Adam and Joe on XFM. Stay tuned. That's Ween with Exactly Where I'm At. This is Adam and Joe on XFM. Now, we want you to call now if you want to enter our competition, Rock and Reel or Rock and Rubs. The number is 0871-222-1049. 0871-222-1049. And if you perform sufficiently impressively in Rock and Reel or Rock and Rubs, you could win like a prize, a free thing, and we'd send it to you. And you could watch it or sell it or just pop it in the bin.
Yeah, but don't be nervous about entering either. It's a very easy competition. All you've got to do is guess which emerging band names are real and which are rubs.
Simple as that.
0871-222-1049. Couldn't be more simple.
Couldn't be more simple.
Couldn't be as simple
don't
as
be
what
careful.
It is.
Okay, we'll be back after these. XFM.
It's all lies, Adam.
I don't understand.
Things are lies.
What?
If you see something nice, it's a lie.
Underneath, it is horrible.
But I thought she was having fun and everything was nice.
No, children are mugging old ladies.
What?
Crack whores and their pimpies are selling their pits on the streets.
I didn't realise. I thought everything was fine out there.
No, it's not. It's horrible. And the coppers have taken away her licence.
The filth, even.
The filth. The pigs.
So she's riding her bike.
She's riding her bike.
I wonder if she's riding it recklessly.
Probably.
I bet she is. I bet it's one of those tiny bikes. And she's just weaving in and out of the traffic without a helmet on.
A little chopper.
A tiny chopper.
She's
got a little chopper.
And she's not stopping at the lights.
No.
She's just going out and she's going the wrong way up one-way streets.
Up.
Up the chopper. And
up the chopper.
It's a shame.
Hey, this is Adam and Joe on XFM. Good morning. Good Saturday morning. It's a bit too early, really. If you're in bed, your brain's awake, but your body's asleep, I'd go back to sleep. I mean, it's a miserable day. It's all grey and windy. Hello?
Yeah,
my, my own.
Yeah, you carry
yeah,
on.
Yeah, I've got nothing else to say. I'm running out of words. There's some sort of crisis in this in the studio.
I thought we were going to do the competition now, but we're not going to do it right now.
What?
We're going to do it after the next song.
Xanthi.
It's not Xanthi's fault. Come on.
It is. Look at her.
She's got a nice pink top.
She has
on.
That, yeah.
That was one of the most sexist things I've ever said.
Wow. So the competition is coming up. It's called Rock and Rubs or Rock and Reel. You have to guess what band names are real and what are rubs. It's a good one.
It's fantastic. And it's relatively easy as well. So if you're lucky enough to get through, you're more or less guaranteed a prize.
Do we still need callers?
No, we've got
a,
we just have to call someone back. Yeah, but we just didn't call them back. Xanthi was too busy looking pretty. In the meantime, that was a joke that time. The first time I genuinely meant that she had it. Well, I'm getting into terrible trouble here. I'm going to play some New York Dolls. Mock Rock. The New York Dolls. I watched
Mock
a fantastic...
Rock?
I'm joking. That's what Bob Harris said about the New York Dolls when they first appeared on the test. I saw a great film about one of the New York Dolls, Killer Kane, Arthur Killer Kane. He was the bass player. And it's an amazing story because it tracks the fact that after the New York Dolls broke up, Arthur Killer Kane was very bitter about the fact that, you know, they broke up so quickly. They were only together for a couple of years before they were ripped apart by the twin terrors of drink and drugs. And, you know, David Johansen, the lead singer, went on to have much more success than poor old Arthur Killer Kane, who ended up working in a Mormon library in L.A. Anyway, this amazing documentary, which is called New York Doll, and I highly recommend it, charts the fact that he was pulled out of obscurity once again for one final gig with the New York Dolls at Morrissey's Meltdown, because Morrissey was like the biggest New York Dolls fan ever in the world. And so this really sweet guy, Arthur Killer Kane, who's tortured by bitterness and dreams of what could have been, gets to have his wish and go and play at the Royal Festival Hall, this amazing gig, which was brilliant. They played a blinder. And then 22 days later, he died. Went back to the States, was diagnosed with leukemia, and 2 hours after he was diagnosed, he was dead. It's such a sad but strangely uplifting story. And I really recommend it. New York Doll. Anyway, sorry about that little tangent. Is everyone depressed now?
No,
should we play a competition?
No.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, jeez. Rock and reel, or rock and rubs. Are the bands real, or are they just rubbish? Rock and reel, or rock and rubs. Are they real, or are they rubs? Yes, it's time for the competition. Rock and what's it called? Rock and Reel or Rock and Rubs?
Yeah,
it's a catchy title, and we've got a contestant on the line. What's the contestant's name, Xanthi?
Matthew.
Hello, Matthew.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine, thanks, Matthew. How are you?
All right, thanks.
More detail, mate. Come on, more to chew
more
on.
More detail.
Yeah,
well,
just
I'm sitting in a car on the A3 right now.
Right. Where are you going?
I'm going to a mate's house right now.
Why are you going to a mate's house in there?
Well, just for the hell of it, hey?
Really?
Because you've got, I can, I think. Yeah.
You've got kind of a freewheeling accent there.
You sound very rich. Are you very, very rich, Matthew?
I wish I was,
What kind of a car are you driving?
BMW.
You see? I knew it.
Are you,
I knew
are you
it.
Wearing,
what do you do for a living?
Are you wearing salmon pink corduroys?
Oh, no. I'm wearing a pair of khaki pants, actually.
Are you friends with Duncan from Blue?
No.
Or Duncan Goodhue?
No, I promise you, I'm not, eh?
And how's your rock knowledge? Do you think you're going to be able to...
Well, I consider myself to be a bit of a rockhead, eh, I think.
What's your... Are you slightly South African?
I am, yes.
Ah, there we go. So you're not just slightly South African, you are South African.
Oh, kind of, yeah. Probably.
Yeah,
well,
that's cool. Well done. Okay, are you ready for this competition, then?
Yeah, I am. Yes, I am, yeah.
So all you have to do, I'm going to read out 10 names in the style of the shipping forecast.
Brilliant.
Brilliant. No reason for it being like the shipping forecast at all. But I'm going to read out 10 names. 5 of them are real band names picked from the gig section of the NME from the last couple of weeks. And the other 5 are rubbish. So all you have to do after each name is say the word real or rubs, depending on whether you think they are real or rubbish. Have I explained that sufficiently well?
No, you've explained that 100% down the...
Hey, Matthew, what's your target score? What are you looking to score?
I get 10 out of 10, eh?
You're going to get 10 out of 10?
I want to get 10 out of 10.
Well, I'll tell you, if you get over 7 out of 10, then you're eligible for a prize.
Okay.
Is that how it goes down?
I've decided that's how it goes
Ruth
down.
That's Ruth.
That's really nice of you, thanks.
Yeah, there's no Ruths here. Okay, are you ready to play Rock and Reel or Rock and Rubs?
I am.
Here
we
go.
I really am.
Number 1. Oh no, not him.
Matthew? No, I say Rubs.
He says Rubs.
Yeah.
Number two, Fury of the Head Teachers.
Yeah, rock. I'll say that's real.
Number three, Vault the Atomizer.
Rubs.
Number four, The Mulattoes.
Yeah, rock, real.
Number five, The United Kingdom of America.
Okay.
That scrambled everyone's brains.
The United Kingdom of America.
Yeah, that's right.
Number six. If I said you had a beautiful body, would you bury it close to me?
Rubs.
Number seven. Lady Fuzz.
Rock.
Number eight. Filthy Pedro and the Intolerable Kid.
Yeah, I'd say that's real.
Number nine. Memorex Harrison.
What? Rubs there.
Number ten. Hecate enthroned.
Ooh.
Ooh. Okay, real.
There you go. That concludes Rock and Real or Rock and Roll. I can tell you there that you scored 7 out of 10.
Hey,
congratulations.
Get in there. Are you going to tell him which ones he got right or wrong, or is someone else going to play later and try and beat that score?
Oh, say again, say. What did you say?
I think someone else should play later.
You're
I'm just talking to Adam, Matthew, sorry. But
okay.
Yeah, because we might run out of stuff to do in the last hour.
Well, I've got a different one. You see, I've got a whole new one as well.
Oh, we blooming hedge. Go on,
I think
then.
We should tell him, because otherwise people
will
just forget.
Okay, we're going to put you out of your misery, Matthew.
Okay.
Okay.
So, Oh No, Not Him. You thought that was Rubs. That's a real band.
Okay.
Oh No, Not Him. Fury of the Head Teachers, they're real. Vaults, the Atomizer, rubbish. The Mulattoes, you thought they were real. That's Rubs.
You see, I'm surprised that's Rubs.
You know, yeah, well, sooner or later.
I bet you there is a band called the Mulattoes.
I searched for them. They weren't there. Number five, the United Kingdom of America. Deal with that, Tony B. Liar and George Bush. That's a real band. You thought that was Rubs. If I said you had a beautiful body, would you bury it close to me? You correctly identified that as Rubs. Lady Fuzz, they're real. Filthy Pedro and the Intolerable Kid, the spelt T-H-E-E. They're real. Memorex Harrison, they're not real. Hecate Enthroned, they're real. All of which you guessed. So congratulations, Matthew.
Thank you very much.
A prize winner. Which prize would you like, Joe? What's he got?
I'd love the DJ Shadow tickets, sir.
Oh, yeah, good one.
There you go. He knew exactly what
he's
wanted.
He's actually been listening.
Yeah. There you go. A pair of tickets to see DJ Shadow on the 15th of December at the Carling Academy, Brixton. Can you make that date, Matthew?
I most definitely
in your
will.
BMW. With your, no doubt.
About the BMW.
Yeah.
So, right. Matthew, thank you so much for calling in. You were fantastic. Have a great weekend.
Thank you, mate.
We'll be back shortly.
Thank you very much. XFM.
Yeah, that was Valerie by the Zootons. That's the second single from the Liverpool Quintet's second album, Tired of Hanging Around. This is Adam and Joe on XFM, London's 104.99999.
London. That's our jingle.
Jingle.
Okay, now I'm going to do a review for something I haven't seen yet.
Terrific. Is it going to be a film or a concert or something else?
It's going to be a film.
A film?
Yeah. It's going to be a review for the film Through a Scanner Darkly.
Right, it's just called A Scanner Darkly, I think, the film is, isn't it?
I wouldn't know, I haven't seen it.
Well, fair enough.
Is it called A Scanner Darkly?
Yeah.
Okay, there you go. A Scanner Darkly.
And it's directed by Richard Linklater.
Linklater.
And it's all got cartooning on the top.
A while ago, I saw a very brief mention of this film in a paper, but since then, the only research I've done is looking at the poster.
Well, you're in a perfect position to give it a thorough review.
Yeah, here we go. Apparently, A Scanner Darkly is a sci-fi fantasy set in a dystopian future where the boundaries between fantasy and reality have become blurred by weird drugs given to people by the government or something like that.
Oh no, I've lost got his pieces of paper confused. That was going so professionally. To be honest, listeners, I was a bit intimidated by the speed and confidence with which Adam launched into that sketch-style review. But now the whole thing's gone tits up and he looks like a complete arsewipe because he's lost his pieces of paper.
What
I can tell
jerk.
You, I, the one who hasn't done any work and hasn't prepared anything, am looking pretty good. Having done nothing, and Adam having made some work, but now getting all confused, is looking like a knobber.
Do you know what happened?
What?
I didn't print out the final page.
brilliant.
You are delighted, aren't you?
I'm so delighted.
You are
it
delighted.
Serves you right for doing some work.
Serves you right for caring.
Serves you right for caring. You know? So there we go. Well, then.
And next week, I can't even do it next week because it'll be so pathetic that
no,
I've
it won't,
brought
no,
it,
won't.
It in again.
Everyone will have forgotten.
Really?
Well done, man. You know, I'm sure it would have been really funny. Can you remember anything of it?
I could probably paraphrase it, but I took ages to write
it. I bet
it.
You did. Oh, okay. But it's the thought that counts.
Yeah.
And that's all we can cling on to.
Well, listen, I've prepared more stuff that I actually did bring with me, including my call to McVitie's about Jaffa Cakes. That's coming up in the next hour here on the Adam and Joe radio
yeah,
show.
Yeah, I've prepared some stuff as well, listeners. I left it at home as well. I forgot to print it.
The cat ate it. Also, I want to talk about security measures.
Okay.
New security measures.
Well, I'd get rid of that jazz music in the background because security measures are nothing to do with a jazz attitude. In fact, I'd say they're the opposite to jazz.
No, this is security jazz.
Is it security jazz? Very yeah. uptight jazz.
Yeah, it's absolutely fine.
Very thoroughly screened jazz.
I just, you know, with all the misery that's been going on this week at the airports and stuff and the high terror alert and everything, I was thinking of some new security measures that maybe they could implement. Anyway, we'll talk about all that in the second hour here on XFM. But before that, we have adverts and, of course, the news.
Ooh.
We'll be back very soon. XFM.
Crikey, that nice harmonious note at the end only just compensates for the rock washing machine that was the rest of that track.
That's a smash. The View from the Afternoon, that's the Arctic Monkeys. And that's the fourth single to be taken mm-hmm. from the Sheffield. They could release every single one of those songs because they're all amazing on that album. And I would imagine that they intend to do so as well. This is Adam and Joe on XFM. Now, of course, unless you were living under a rock this week, you would have been aware of the fact that we are now... Are we currently at the critical threat alert
yeah.
level?
Yeah, Britain is at critical threat alert level.
So there are five... Could you name the five alert levels, Joe?
Yeah. Level... well, what does it go 1 to 5 or 5 to 1? Is 1 the most or least threatening? What order do you want?
I would say 1 is the least threatening.
Okay. Level 1 is Sal Cool. It's just S apostrophe A-double-L-K-O-double-L. Sal Cool.
Yeah.
Just means everything's cool. It's all cool.
Okay.
Said in a Rastafarian accent.
Yeah.
Sal Cool is number 1. Number 2 is what? It's just W-H-A-T with a question mark. What? It's like something might be going down in the peripheral vision. What? And then in brackets, easy, man. Because it's all right. It was nothing serious. Number 3 is get off me.
Yeah.
These are the Rastafarian state of alert.
Threat levels.
Get off me. That's someone's approaching and like, maybe it's don't mess with me. This is turning into sort of a Jim Davidson sketch from the mid-70s. Number 4 is just stop it. I think generally stop it. Number 4, everyone has to stop everything.
Yeah.
I've dropped the rest of the thing. I was getting a bit worried.
You go back to it for number 5, which is critical.
Critical. Critical.
And we are currently at critical. You see, I came up with some new ones as well. They're not quite as good as your ones.
Well, how could they be?
My one, lowest threat level, number 1, is just scary.
Right.
And that's people on TV, basically. And this is what happens, because the real ones, let me tell you, are low, an attack is unlikely.
Low.
Moderate, an attack is possible, but not likely. Substantial, an attack is a strong possibility. Severe, an attack is highly likely, and critical, an attack is expected immediately. So my ones
are... So that's what we're at, an attack is expected immediately.
Yeah, that's not good, is it? That's why we're trying to cheer people
anyway,
up.
Anyway, but listen, this is a, you know, we don't want to mess with anything serious here, do we? Do we?
Yes.
Yes,
So my ones are scary. This is the lowest level.
Sure these aren't just the Spice Girls?
They were invented by the Spice Girls.
Right.
I had some help from Jerry Halliwell with these. Lowest level, scary. People on TV are saying it's only a matter of time before there's another attack. Poo pants. Level 2. People on TV have said that the attack will probably be in a few weeks. Oh, Jesus. That's level 3. Channel 4 launches a season of documentaries about all the various ways that we're about to be attacked and how underprepared we are for it.
Mm.
Level 4. Stuffed. Channel 4 has to pull the documentary season because an attack is so likely it can no longer be treated as entertainment. And number 5, Armageddon. Channel 4 runs Armageddon, starring Bruce Willis.
Why would they do that?
Round the clock, to take the minds of the population off
right,
the attacks.
Right, or to blur the lines between entertainment and true terror.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. I think they should just arrange the Spice Girls in ascending order of panic. So it would be Baby, would be like the Baby Spice Alert, would be everything's fine, it's quite innocuous. Then you'd have Sporty, which is, you know, get physically prepared, because something might be going down, so get fit. Then at number 3, it would be Ginger, which is just unnerving.
Well, it's Amber, isn't it?
You're almost Amber Alert, yeah. Exactly. Alternatively known as Strawberry Blonde. At number 4 would be Posh, because that just means get yourself posh, get organised, get, you know.
Yeah, get in the bunker.
Get in the bunker, get in the posh bunker. And of course, number 5 would be Scary.
Yeah, very good.
Yeah.
So those are our new terror threat
alerts.
Were
you going to talk about like ways to make flying more secure?
Yeah, I've got some new measures, but I'd like to talk about those a bit later.
Because it crossed my mind that nude flying would be the key.
That was one of my measures.
Yeah, nudist clubs.
Well, maybe people can text in as well. It should be said, of course, that we have nothing but respect and admiration for the security services and the way that they're protecting us. Mm. But these are just ideas for extra things they could be doing to make us even safer, if such a thing is possible. If you've got any ideas for how to make us absolutely 100% safe, then give us a call or text us. In fact, text is probably the best way. And what's the text again?
83XFM. And is this specifically in the air?
Yeah, I guess let's limit it to the airports now. Things you can do at the airports. For example, I was thinking that you could have Darren Brown would be at the gate and he would hypnotise you and then he would ask you if you're carrying any weapons or explosives.
Mm. Well, he'd be able to tell which hand they were in.
Exactly.
If you had one.
Yeah.
He'd be able to do that on 300 people in succession without getting it wrong once.
There'd be no hiding the explosives from him. Yeah. He would find them.
There's only one of him, though.
I know. There would be terrible queues.
Well, he could be maybe on BA, Transatlantic. And they're the most vulnerable.
Okay, who would you get for the other airlines?
That bloke, Street Magic Man. You know, the low-rent one on ITV.
I know the guy you mean.
What's he called? I can't remember his name.
The Wizbot.
And then in America, you could, of course, have David Blaine.
Yeah.
Suspended in some kind of tank. Checking for terrorists.
Yeah, he doesn't have any weapons. He doesn't have any bombs. No, he doesn't have any either.
That's how he would.
That's
say.
How he'd say it.
So anyway, there's one idea for you. If you've got any others,
that's just to get the ball rolling.
That's to get the ball rolling.
Yeah.
Text us 83XFM immediately. Let's have some.
There'll
more
be a
music.
Prize for the best ones.
Absolutely. And this is Justice versus Simeon.
Oh,
Joe,
I like this.
Your favorite
I like
track.
This. I love this. Yeah, that's the Rapture with Get Myself Into It. If you want to help him get into it, because he wants you to help him do it, and it really is the chance of a lifetime for him, then simply get in touch with the Rapture at 28 Rapture Street, London, SE. I don't know.
Before that, you heard We Are Your Friends, Justice versus Simeon. This is Adam and Joe. On XFM.
Yep. This morning, whilst not making light of the extraordinary and important job that British security services are doing at our airports to keep us all safe, we're also suggesting stupid security measures. Not stupid even, maybe sensible ones.
Some of these are very sensible.
Radical moves.
Extra precautions they could take to keep us all safe.
Yeah.
You were mentioning earlier on the idea of just making passengers be nude.
Yeah, it was very popular in the 70s, nudism, before everybody got all afraid of each other's bits and bobs. But it's time to bring it back with naked flying. I thought maybe the airlines could introduce little panties with a BA logo on them, or Virgin. The Virgin would have something written on them, like, ooh,
you
sexy.
Could, yeah, you could make it out of the same fabric that they put the flaps on the headrests, you know what I'm
saying?
Yeah,
they wouldn't be pants that you could wear the next day. They'd just start disintegrating after 11 or 12 hours.
Sexy.
Yeah, because which would be an extra bonus. But imagine how sexy the flight would be.
Well, exactly. You know, now that they've banned carry-on luggage for the foreseeable future, well,
you know, that would be a good name for a carry-on film set during this crisis.
Carry-on luggage.
Carry-on luggage.
And the thing that you know, if the passengers were forced to be nude, that would be ideal. Barbara Windsor with little sort of
nipple tassels. Yeah,
so they could check she wasn't hiding bombs in her boobs.
You see, that would be the next step, though. Of course, if you had fake breasts, they'd have to somehow check what was in there. because they'd have one chemical in the right breast, another chemical in the left breast.
Right.
And then boing them together in the loo.
Jordan's not going to be going
Jordan's
anywhere
not
for a while.
No. So listen, here are some of the texts that have come in. This idea is from Tim in a car. He said, from Tim in a car. And to me, that gives him extra authority.
Is a car
passed,
somewhere
he's passed his test.
In the Middle East?
Maybe, yeah. Maybe he's
a car
in the Middle East. Mm. Here is my idea, says Tim. Put all the baggage on one plane and all the passengers on another. Then get a pilot who's a bit depressed to fly the plane with the bags on so he won't be too bothered if it comes a cropper.
That's a very good idea. Separate planes for bags.
Yeah, but you'd still scan the bags in the bag plane.
Yeah, of course. No, you're not going to wantonly just...
Yeah, but this is, if you were a conspiracy theorist, you might think that they were just trying to make more money off fizzy drinks.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and off their telly services.
Yeah, exactly.
The next thing is they'll start charging for films, won't they? They won't let you bring anything on board, then they'll start charging to see Firewall.
Well, they used to charge for headphones, do you remember?
They did, didn't they?
They might still do that
they
on
They do
certain
on non-transatlantic flights,
yeah.
But that's a good idea, Tim. Everyone should learn to fly their own mini planes whilst being very wary of giving lifts to strangers with unusually bulky clothing, says Andrew Cottier in Little Venice.
That's a very good point, Andrew. Very pragmatic.
Jason says, how about we stop bombing other countries to secure America's future fuel supplies?
Well, we can't read that one out, unfortunately, because it has a political bias on it.
We can't, so we won't read that one out.
No.
But it's a fair point.
It's a fair point, though, Jason.
I'm just filtering the texts for...
obscenities.
ones.
An insane political bent.
Freeze everybody boarding a plane. That comes from Aid. So all liquid explosives would be inert. And you'd have the nice added advantage of having had a good rest. But I agree, some sort of drug, a knockout drug, or some kind of sleep capsule, you know? I've always wondered why they don't have... Japanese capsule hotels where you sleep in a tube?
Yeah.
Why not just stack tubes in a honeycomb in a plane generally, have a little parachute packed into each one? So if there's an accident, they all just break out.
Like little capsules,
little capsule, and they all just float to the sea.
So you're responsible for your own capsule.
There's a telly in there.
Yeah.
There's warm bedding. There's a little air supply. You'd be fine, even if you sunk to the bottom of the sea. You'd be fine for several days, and there'd be a thing, boom, boom. That would alert the security.
So the whole idea of living in communal society slightly goes out the window.
Well, when you're on a plane, you don't want to know about
other
people.
You know,
either.
That's the price you pay for security, isn't it, sometimes?
Yeah.
And the other thing I was thinking you could do is you could have those voice analysis experts chat to everybody who goes through the gates.
Mm.
Also, that would take a very, very long time and cause massive chaos and delays in the airports. But you would, you know, they'd analyze your voice to see if you were lying. They'd maybe make a program about it for daytime TV, and then they'd get the results back a few weeks later. And
what about Total Recall technology?
Yeah,
that's that x-ray machine out of the film Total Recall, a full body x-ray as you walk past. That's the way to go, isn't it?
Yeah, but that didn't help they didn't screen out the
in Total Recall.
Yeah, the lady
it
who
didn't
comes
work
through, well, it was Arnold, wasn't
recall.
It?
Yes.
Arnold came through with the bomb head. Do you remember?
Yeah, that it's true. How about a magnetized floor on planes?
Mm-hmm.
This is from Tom. If it's being hijacked, the pilot pushes a button. Pushes a violet button. He specified the colour of the button. And the hijacker's nail scissors fly to the floor. Well, Tom, you're living in the past. Nail scissors are no longer a threat. They're not allowed on anyway.
No, exactly. You have to pop those in the bin.
Yeah.
With all the other goodies. Yeah.
You know what? I might have to vet the other texts before I read them. Because, of course, on the radio, you have to be balanced.
Exactly. We don't want to express any kind of political bias.
Otherwise, keep your ideas coming in.
We'd be in trouble.
83XFM is the text number, and we'll give a prize to the best way to, you know, get everyone back in the air safely again.
Now, we still have my...
Xanthi's looking a bit... You're looking a bit worried about this whole thing.
It's okay. We'll get shouted at this week by head of XFM. No, we're not...
Anything bad we're not doing.
We're not doing it.
Good. Just, if you're worried, don't worry, it's fine.
It's fine.
It's all fine.
So, Joe, do you want to introduce this next free play? This is a bizarre version.
Yeah, this is weird. No one's going to like this, but you've got to hear it. It's by a Norwegian band, and it's a cover of Bonnie Tyler's Total Eclipse of the Heart, listeners. And the important thing to know is that the percussionist is playing the rhythm on old domestic appliances. So it's kind of art rock.
Do you know what they're called, the band?
Yeah, they're called Hurrah Tornado.
Curato Nero.
And if you check out the video on the internet, he's doing it live. He's just smashing washing machines up to provide the beat. But for me, this brings out more of the emotion than Bonnie Tyler did of this song, which is about sort of being a feeling middle-aged and trapped in a sort of boring domestic existence. You know, every now and then I get a little bit lonely, a little bit worried that the best of all the years has gone by.
Yeah.
And here is that song brought to new life by this Norwegian band. Hit it.
Turn around.
Every now and then I feel a little bit lonely and you're never coming round.
Turn around.
Every now and then I get a little bit tired of listening to the sound of my tears. Every now and then I get a little bit nervous that the best of all the years have gone by. Every now and then I get a little bit terrified, but then I see the look in your eye. Every now and then I fall apart. Every now and then I fall apart. And I need you now tonight. And I need you more than ever. And if you only hold me tight, we'll be holding on forever. And we'll always be making it right. Cause we'll never be wrong. Together we can take it to the end of the line. My love is like a shadow on you all of the time. I don't know what to do and I'm always in the dark. The rhythm in my body can't give giving one spark. I really love you tonight. Forever's gonna start tonight. Forever's gonna start tonight. Once upon a time I was falling in love, but now I'm only falling apart. Nothing I can say, a total eclipse of the heart.
Why did you stop it?
I haven't stopped it yet.
It's about to get good. He's about to take it out on a dishwasher.
Nothing I can do, a total eclipse of the heart.
There goes the microwave.
The Muppet Show, this is the kind of stuff they should have on it.
Yeah.
Oh, that's beautiful. Don't you think that's beautiful?
Joe, I thought it was smashing. It's a bit like the Flaming Lips or something in there as well.
Yeah, that's good. I like that. That's Hurrah Tornado. They're Norwegian. I think they're called... No, Torpedo, not Tornado. Hurrah Torpedo, something like that.
Yeah. You won't find that on John Kennedy's show, will you? This is Adam and Joe on XFM. We'll be back shortly. XFM. That's fantastic. I love that song. In the Morning, The Coral. This is Adam and Joe here on XFM.
It is the morning, isn't it?
It's still technically the morning. Yes, it is. You've got 23 more minutes left of the morning. And what a
rubbish morning it is.
Rotten morning. I had to wear my jeans today. I thought I had a couple more months of short wearing to do.
Good news, though. My cat, Macy, came in for the first time in 6 months.
Came in from the cold.
Well, she's been sleeping outside the whole time.
She's been spying.
She just comes in to be fed in a very arrogant manner.
Yeah.
Not doing her job.
That's what cats
not
are
being
like.
Not being purry, yeah. Not approaching, not going on the knee, nothing. Yeah. Just feed me, I'm back out. Feed me, I'm back out. That's what it's been like for the whole summer.
That's what it's like having children.
Then, to this morning, it's rainy, she decides to come in and curl up on the sofa.
Mm-hmm.
Which is very good news. I gave her a little tickle on the tummy and a stroke and she purred and it's just like the old days.
Oh, you reunited with your long lost
prodigal cat.
That's nice, man.
Yeah.
But what happened to the heat wave? It wasn't really a heat wave so much as
a
heat ripple, really. I could have handled a bit more of that. You know, everyone's saying, oh, it's a disaster. Britain's just dying in the heat wave.
It'll come back, man. It'd better come back for next week. I'm going to the Green Man Festival in Wales.
Oh, really?
And if it's all rainy, then I'm going to complain.
Yeah.
So it's going to come back next weekend, I'm confident.
You reckon?
Bang. Tropical.
Do we know what the forecast is?
Forecast.
The forecast.
Jamie Foxx.
What are you talking about?
Jamie Foxx's song Forecast.
Forecast?
Yeah, never mind. Just
about someone who gets a fork stuck in their bottom.
So should we do more security texts?
Yeah, let's polish that off. Why not?
A bit worried. So here's another good one. Here is it. Where is it? Hang on. Phil. Adam. Phil.
Oh, Phil. Sorry. I thought you were saying you had one from Phil. Phil. Adam. Phil. A lot of texts from people called Phil. This is me filling. This is quite good, isn't it? This is why we're going to get a Sony Award. Hey, incidentally, Adam and Joe news. I probably shouldn't mention this, but we're on Bravo at the moment. The first series of our show, Shock Video, is being repeated on Bravo, as I discovered. I stumbled across it last night. I think it's on about 11 o'clock, pretty much every weeknight. And I hesitate to mention it because it's a total disgrace. It's absolutely awful. And it's a disaster area. Basically, it's me and Joe kind of talking over clips from softcore porn
shows.
Don't
watch it. What we're saying is don't watch it.
Don't watch it.
Switch on Bravo.
But if there's any way that you can figure out, like, whether they've started running series two, then hang in for that. Because series two, it suddenly turns round and we sort of get what the whole thing's about and it becomes brilliant.
Okay, that's enough filling.
Yeah.
Compulsory straitjackets on board the plane.
Right.
Yeah? Or onboard petting zoos, where a nation of animal lovers, no bad things would happen if everybody had a little pet to pet. Do you think that's a good idea?
Well, the terrorizers, they don't have any respect for pets. They'd probably stick a bomb right in a gerbil or something.
That's from Sean Bark in Birchington.
Yeah.
I'm trying to find the one. Someone suggested sleeping gas. So you get on the plane, mm-hmm. you get comfortable, and then the hostess says, ladies and gentlemen, we hope you're feeling relaxed. Secure your tray table in the seat in front and put your seat in the recline position and breathe deeply because we're now administering sleeping gas into the passenger compartment.
We will revive you 45 minutes before landing in accordance with regulations.
Everyone falls unconscious.
But you see, the problem is that the rotties would have some special thing. They'd stick something up
nose
their
plugs.
Nose plugs, you know. They'd have a little breathing canister or something, and they'd pretend to be asleep, and then they'd pop up halfway through the flight. First, they'd nick everyone's wallets,
yeah,
and then they'd wreak their sort of
havoc,
peculiar brand of havoc.
Here's one from Kath in Cardiff. She says helium. It would help the plane to float, which is always good, but everyone will be so busy making funny voices they'll forget to do anything bad.
They'll all just be giggling.
Yeah, giggling. But that, if something bad did happen, that would make it even more terrifying. Like some kind of a mass murder in a funfair.
Insane giggling.
Exactly.
So listen, should we give a prize to one of these people?
I don't know whether any of them deserve prizes.
They all deserve prizes. It's a question of which one we actually choose random. Let's just choose one at random.
Really? I'm going to have to play another song. And
what about Sleeping Gas Guy?
Yeah, I can't. Oh, yeah, here we go. Who's that? That's Joe in Kingston. Yeah, Joe in Kingston, you've won. Well done.
Congratulations. Thank you very much for texting everybody who texted.
You know, the other solution to this whole problem is just don't fly. Because let's face it, it's massively environmentally pollutive.
Mm-hmm.
It's extraordinarily high levels of consumption of fossil fuels. It's bloody noisy over me and Adam's houses.
Yeah.
Like one plane every 2 minutes. The London skies are teeming with aeroplanes.
Well, the skies of the world are teeming with aeroplanes.
No, most cities don't allow planes to fly over them.
Really?
London does, yeah. London's got more planes above it than any other city, I'm pretty convinced. It's noisy, it's uncomfortable, it's boring. And if we all went on holiday in England, which we can do now that we've got tropical summers, then it's good for the national economy and everybody's happy. So just stop flying.
That's true.
That's what Joe Cornish says.
Well, you know
flying's
what?
Flying's rubbish. It's
certainly
horrible.
If you
it's
can
like
avoid
torture.
It. Yeah, exactly. I mean,
just pack it in, give it up.
Door to door, if you go, like, because I went to France recently, I flew out there, had to fly with the family, but then on the way back, came back for the show and went on the train.
Yeah.
And door to door, it's the same length of journey. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like 6 hours.
Exactly, on the train. Take the trains. Trains are lovely. Alternatively, what about this? Massive water skiing pyramids.
Mm-hmm.
Same number of people as in a plane, all on water skis, being dragged behind one boat.
Would you dress them as nuns?
Yes.
That's a good idea.
And you water ski to America.
That's a really good idea. Hey, folks, don't forget that the X List is coming up in the final hour. It's we're only giving you 15 minutes notice this week, but that's enough time. You can get your requests in for classic X List tracks, you know, indie smashes, that kind of thing, from the XFM vaults, and you can dedicate them to whoever you want. It's a chance for us to connect and say thank you in a way to all the people that listen to the show. We might ring you up for a chat. It's all going to be very friendly, and of course, I've still got my call to McVitie's about the Jaffa Cakes to play you guys. That's all coming up here on XFM. But now it's time for more music, and this is The Killers.
Would you lie with me and just forget?
No, I'm not going to lie with you.
What I'd do is, if I was singing it, I'd go right at the end.
Just forget the world.
And break down like Michael Jackson.
Yeah. Like that.
Yeah, that you'd sell a lot more records. That was Snow. Was that Snow Patrol?
That was the delightful sound of Snow Patrol.
Yeah, well done, Snow Patrol.
With Chasing Cars.
So listen, you're a big fan of Paris Hilton, right, Adam?
I love Paris Hilton. She's amusing and very attractive.
Yeah, well, there's an interview with her in GQ, and listeners, you might be interested in this. It's Piers Morgan interviewing her, right?
He does quite
good interviews in GQ.
Does he?
So they're talking about whether she would call herself a celebrity, and Paris Hilton is denying. She doesn't like the word celebrity. Piers Morgan says, yeah, but you dance on tables in nightclubs. Paris Hilton says, no, I don't dance on tables. Piers Morgan says, yes, you do. I've seen you. Hilton says, no, I dance on the banquettes just below the tables because I don't want to be on the dance floor with everyone sweating on me. It's gross. Morgan says, I thought the whole point of clubbing was to get horribly sweaty. Hilton says, no, I hate sweat. It grosses me out.
That's a fair point.
Morgan says, a lot of American women seem to have that issue. Why? Hilton, I don't want to talk about it while I eat. Sweat really grosses me out.
Yeah.
That's one of the things that's really cool about her. She's repulsed by anything sort of human.
Mm.
She wants everybody to be as perfect as her. She hates sweat, the idea of sweat.
Man, if she hates sweat that much, she must get very upset when it's time to go to the lavvy.
What? Why?
Just because, can you imagine? You know, she'd be weeping.
Oh, because she'd hate her body for doing these disgusting things.
Exactly.
What about when she makes sweet love to people? Well, does she not work up a sweat?
She doesn't make sweet love
very
often.
I tend to get very sweaty.
I read that she is frustrated because people assume that she's an easy lay.
In this very interview, hey, steady on with the language. Like crisps, Lay's crisps.
Exactly.
She's very, you can make friends with her if you give her some Lay's crisps.
I was thinking of like the Hawaiian wreath things.
A Lay, yeah. So here we go. Piers Morgan also asks her, are you interested in world affairs? Paris Hilton, yes, I'm interested in poverty.
Mm-hmm.
Morgan, which aspects of poverty intrigue you, Paris? Hilton, I want to go to Africa and raise awareness. What, about her? No, about Africa.
Yeah, they're pretty much aware of the situation in Africa, I think.
Hilton, I do a lot for charity. Morgan, how much have you personally donated? I don't know. Ask my manager. Ask my money manager. I don't know where this is going, actually. But basically, this comes around to her wanting to be a princess.
Mm-hmm.
She decides she wants to be a princess, and she reckons she's going to marry Prince William and become Princess Hilton.
That's nice. Yeah, because
now, that's feasible, isn't it?
It's perfectly feasible.
That's the kind of thing, in fact, that should happen, because it would make older people disgusted by what's happened to the world.
Yeah.
And that's what should go on, right?
Yeah, exactly.
And it'll make her a proper beautiful princess.
That's true.
And
that's
it'll make William very happy.
But no, I read that, you know, she's only had relations with two people, she reckons.
She says she's only slept with two people,
and she was unlucky enough to be filmed by one of them and have the film released all over the world. So people assume that she's filthy, but that's not the case. Anyway, listen, we've got the news coming up, and then it is time for the X List. So get your X List requests in, adamandjoe@xfm.co.uk, or you can text 83XFM with any request from the XFM vaults, and we'll pick the best and play them for you. Also, there's that call to McVitie's coming up. That's exciting.
Oh, brilliant.
Come on, stick with it. XFM. That's Beck. Of course, with Loser.
Sorry about that. I'm just readjusting my microphone.
Just adjusting your mic there. Why? Because the news guy messed it up.
Yeah, the news guy made a right mess up of it.
We had a long chat with the news guy about whether you should pronounce the name Pete Doherty or Pete Doherty.
I'm disappointed by news people.
Why?
Ever since we've been in this Saturday morning slot.
Have they let you down?
Well, I expected them to be authoritative and to look as if, were, you know, they to be in a situation that was newsworthy, they would be able to get in there and, you know... They're like policemen in a way.
Well, do you expect all people that read the news to be sort of investigative and to be jumping around the rubble, foiling plots?
Like John Simpson.
Exactly, like John Simpson.
Or Kate Adey.
Or Robert Redford.
Yeah, they've all got to get in there, get proactive. But this guy, his voice actually changes when he reads the news, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
It becomes authoritative. The rest of the time, he looks like just a friendly uncle.
Yeah.
Who might know stuff about backgammon, but not much about the news.
And you, that's not good enough for you. Too casual.
Too casual.
Too casual.
Yeah.
Well, it is XFM.
I think the military should read the news.
Right.
We should have somebody in military, somebody decorated.
Sergeant Major.
Yeah.
Well, what about, you know, because at XFM you'd expect maybe...
Because it's all lies anyway, isn't it?
Do you reckon?
It's all propaganda. It's all government propaganda. That's not the truth. Aliens are here. There are all sorts of stuff going on that we're never told about.
Royal family lizard people.
Royal family of lizards. That would be the real news. Here is the news.
The royal family are definitely lizard people.
That wouldn't even be news. That would just be old. They've shed some skin and they're crawling up the inside of Pig Pen laying eggs.
With Fathers for Justice. Now, tonight, there's a possibility that we might go and see The Shining.
Yes, listeners, if you're at a loose end any night between now and next Saturday, you should check out Somerset House's summer screen season. So last night they showed School of Rock and Nacho Libre.
Hey, what's Nacho Libre like? Bill.
Nacho Libre is really good. Don't listen to idiot critics who've given it one star.
Because I'd heard a couple of bad words about it. People sort of say, it's disappointment.
No, it's good.
It's good.
It's really good. It's a bit like Napoleon Dynamite. You just have to tune into it. And then it's really good. Very funny.
Black is back.
Yeah.
His black best.
Yeah. So I think tonight they're showing The Shining, but I think it's sold out. Sunday they're showing The Outsiders.
Brilliant.
A fantastic film.
That's appropriate as well, because you'll actually be watching it outside.
I'm just going to stab myself with a bar.
Okay. So what's the deal? You go out there, there's no seats.
What
right?
are on the other night? Xanthi, quickly, get on the internet, find out what films are on the other... You got 10 seconds. Go.
Tell me what the
Otherwise
deal is.
Fired.
So do they put seats out there or what?
No, you take a little rug... And there's delicious food, lovely lamb wraps in falafel, you know, is it falafel? I don't know.
Yeah.
But lamb wraps with a bit of yogurt
lamb,
and cucumber.
Bam, I love
That's a
my
lamb.
Lamb.
Wrap.
That's a lamb
Correct.
Wrap.
Correct.
Yeah.
And lovely drinks. And it's like a sort of hippie festival. And they've even got, in case it does a little tinkle of rain,
mm-hmm.
they've even got little plastic Macs, what you can put on.
Well, that's the festival experience in a nutshell, though, isn't
yeah,
it? You've got
yeah.
to expect a little bit of
The Shining
problems.
Will be brilliant tonight. If it's slightly chilly, it'll be extra frightening.
Yeah, especially the bit at the end in the maze.
Oh, it's going to be good. Ooh.
I don't want to hurt you. I just want to bash your brains in.
What are the other films, Anthony?
We've got Big Lebowski next Saturday.
Big Lebowski next Saturday. That'll be good.
Starship Troopers and Aliens.
Yeah, what a double bill.
Man.
Starship Poopers, Goopers and Aliens. What night's that?
That's Friday.
Friday night.
That
get down
would
there.
Be amazing.
But what about like Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday?
We've got Brazil on Thursday.
Brazil Brilliant. Thursday.
Howl's Moving Castle.
Now I think that one's one that there's still tickets available for. Howl's Moving Castle. Beautiful Studio Ghibli movie.
Yeah, that's the most recent one, isn't it?
Yeah.
The Night of the Hunter.
Night of the Hunter. On what night's that?
Tuesday.
That'll be fantastic. Charles Laughton.
I've never seen it.
Oh, it's brilliant. Robert Mitchum.
Uh-huh.
It's fantastic. It's the movie where he's got love and hate tattooed on his knuckles. Incredibly famous and influential. It's a classic. Beautiful.
Yeah.
Amazing, about two little kids on the run from a gangster.
And that's on Tuesday night?
That's Tuesday night. So there are still tickets available for some of those. So if you're at a loose end and you fancy a fantastic film outside, then get in touch with Somerset House. I don't know how. Just do it.
You just type in Somerset House on the internet. And yes.
Or into a typewriter.
Typewriter.
Yeah.
Would it work as well if you wrote it on your face?
Yes.
Oh, gosh, that is brilliant.
Shall we have some X-List request music? We are in the X-List hour of the show. Get your requests in on 83XFM and we'll do our best to play them.
Yeah, and coming up after this track, I'm going to play you my conversation with McVitie's.
Oh, jeepers.
Jeepers creepers. Right now, here is Frank Black. No, it's not Frank Black. I'm going to play some Frank Black later on. This is the Buzzcocks and it's going out to
Doug.
I don't
trust anything you say anymore.
Really?
Is it the Buzzcocks?
Yes. Well, hey!
What? What a load of rubbish.
That's brilliant.
What a load of disgusting nonsense.
That's the Buzzcocks from their Spiral Scratch EP, Breakdown. This is Adam and Joe here on XFM. It's the X List. We've got more amazing music coming up from the XFM vaults very shortly. But now...
What?
It's time to play you my conversations with McVitie's.
McVitie's.
As we said earlier on, we're sort of obsessed with Jaffa Cakes. And the fact that it says on the box of a packet of Jaffa Cakes that they are recommended by sports nutritionists.
Mm.
Something which we find extraordinary.
A little bit disingenuous. Is that the correct word?
Yeah, possibly.
Yeah.
But you know, I mean, it doesn't... All they need to do is pay two sports nutritionists to endorse them, and then they can say anything they want.
Do you think?
Yeah, so it's a legitimate claim.
I don't know. I think the Advertising Standards Authority would take a tougher line than
yeah,
that.
Yeah, because...
They've probably got some logic behind it, haven't
I would
they?
Think that if the majority of sports nutritionists were... You know, if all sports nutritionists in the UK were polled, I don't reckon that they would
no,
all...
No, you don't see Linford Christie stuffing his face with Jaffas
before
a big race, do you?
And it's nothing against Jaffas, because they are lovely.
They're tasty.
But, you know, everything in moderation. You know what I mean?
But this is the logic that sugar, that anything with sugar in it makes you go faster, right?
Yeah.
Because that's how Lucozade can justify being a sports drink.
Okay.
Because it's got glucose in it.
Yes.
And that gives you energy.
That's
but
right.
But it only gives you energy later, doesn't it? It's not instantaneous. Is
no.
it? I don't know. It's contradictory information.
Well, it's a little burst of energy, and then you with a lot of sugary stuff, you get a real bit of lethargy afterwards.
Yeah. Anyway, the other thing it says on the box is that if you've got a problem with Jaffas, if you're addicted to them, call the Jaffaholics anonymous line.
Yeah,
right?
Because they're kind of, it seems like they're kind of...
Tickling you with one hand, spanking you with the other.
Well, they're sort of jokingly saying, go on, get addicted, eat as many as you want. And I thought, that can't be their attitude, can it? So I gave them a call. I was interested to find out what happened if you did call the Jaffaholics line.
Mm.
And it says quite sort of seriously, if you do have a problem, call in the strictest confidence this number. So this is what happened, first of all, when I called the number.
Hi, you're through to McVitie's care line. If you are calling regarding McVitie's Jaffaholics Anonymous, please press 1.
Hello, your call cannot be taken at the moment, so please leave your message after the tone.
Yeah, I've got like a really bad problem with like cakes and eating.
Thank you for calling.
What? What about my problem?
So that was
that
it.
It doesn't give you much time, does it?
It's just a little answering machine, and it's only about 5 seconds worth
That's
of actual
very
message.
Flippant.
So I wasn't going to stand for that, you know. So I called.
Most people
back.
Probably just swear, right?
Yeah.
Most people call up and just say 8 swear words.
And then put
and
the
so,
phone down.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The F1, the C1, the S1.
You know, because...
And then loop them.
Yeah, 5 seconds, that's not enough for anything, not even a good bit of swearing.
Yeah, and you could have a real problem. I mean, some people are addicted to chocolate.
Well, exactly. So this
so
is...
So what are McVitie's playing at?
This is what I wanted to find out, how they would deal with it, if I really did have a problem. So there were two options there. One was for the Jaffaholics line, and the other one was just for the McVitie's care line. So that's the one I tried next.
Hi, you're through to McVitie's care line. If you are calling regarding McVitie's Jaffaholics Anonymous, please press 1. If you would like to speak to a customer services agent about any McVitie's products, please press 2. Good afternoon, McVitie's.
Yeah, I called the problem line, you know, like if you've got a problem.
Right.
And I can't get anyone there. There's like just a machine.
Yes, it is. It's just so you can leave a recorded message.
Can I not talk to anyone about it?
No, not really, because we're not qualified to help you in any way.
Why did they put the number on the packet?
It's just so you can call that line and leave your comment.
Well, it says if you've got a problem.
Right, so do you have a problem then?
Yeah, with like the Jaffas.
Right, and what problem have you got?
Like, I eat a lot of them, you know, too many.
So how many are you eating?
It's like about 10 packets a day.
Yeah, some people say they're eating 15 or 20 a day, so you shouldn't worry too much.
So she's not impressed by that.
15 or 20?
15 or 20 packets.
How many Jaffas in a packet of Jaffas?
At least about
10.
10 or 12.
That's 150 Jaffas a day.
And I'm pretty sure that isn't good for you.
No, that's sport nutrition. You'd become a top-class athlete on that many jeffers.
You could just roll down the track.
Yeah.
So anyway, she's not taking me seriously on the whole I'm addicted to jaffers thing, so I persevere a little bit.
Did you want to leave your name at all, and we'll put you down as being a jaffaholic?
But I'm in trouble, you know, because I can't put on a lot of weight. I'm not eating nothing else, really, you know.
You'll have to try and cut down.
I can't, though, you know. I'm just thinking about them all the time, you know. I like
them. Qualified to help you in here, you see. We're not counsellors at all. All we can do is, you know, just make a note of your comments for you.
Because it says, like, if you've got a problem, you should call, you know.
Yes, well, it was just a fun line. It was just intended as that.
Oh.
If it is that severe, then you really need, you know, counselling help, and we can't help you with that.
But I thought they were, like, recommended by sports nutritionists here. Can I talk to one?
We haven't got a nutritionalist here, so it's probably a call to the doctor that you need. Right.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you for calling anyway. Bye.
Yeah, bye.
She's really sunny. She's not genuinely concerned about my problem at all. She's just trying to fob me off to another agency. It's outrageous.
I think it's brilliant. I think Jaffa Cakes are brilliant, and I think the line's a really good idea. It's just a bit of fun, and you've got the wrong end of the stick.
I do certainly appear to have the wrong end of the stick.
Yeah.
That's completely true. And man, it's not going to stop me eating Jaffas, because I love those Jaffa Cakes.
The Jaffa Cakes are delicious, you know, it's just, like she said, it's just a fun line. It's just a fun line. It's fun. It's so that she can make a note of your problems.
So do you think I took the whole thing too seriously?
I don't know, Adam. I don't know. Yes.
Oh, no.
I think you may have. I don't know. I think you may have.
I can't believe it. I feel
it's
so foolish.
It's not that good just to make a note of the problem, though, is it? What kind of help is that? No, this is just so that we can make a note of your problem. Put you down as a Jaffaholic. There's a list.
Mm.
Some kind of evil list.
Did you hear halfway through she put me on speakerphone as well?
Did she?
Yeah.
So the rest of the office could hear Mr. Nutter.
Mr. Nutbar.
People are texting in saying apparently Rio Ferdinand was caught on camera munching Jaffa Cakes during some sort of football match.
There you go. Maybe they are recommended by sports
nutritionists. Well, they would have paid him. Don't you think they would have slipped some Jaffas and made some kind of backstage deal? I'm merely speculating.
Man, you don't have to bribe me to munch on Jaffas. They're delicious. Let's play some music now.
They're dangerlicious.
They're deadlicious. this is going out to Shelley. Shelley's at work. She's babysitting some horses and an incontinent dog. That's what it says here on the piece of paper I was handed.
That sounds revolting.
She's babysitting.
Imagine.
You know, because as soon as you say babysitting horses,
The horses are kicking her. She's landing in the feces of the incontinent dog.
They might just be watching telly.
Alternatively.
Anyway, this is going out to you, Shelley. Take care of those horses and the dogs. This is Daft Punk. That's Daft Punk with Digital Love. A breezy, summery kind of sound, and it's opened up a little chink in the clouds. I can see a tiny little bit of blue sky. we've got X-List for the rest of the hour here on XFM. That's another half an hour, so keep your requests coming in, and we're going to play another round of Rock and Reel or Rock and Rubs very shortly, so stay tuned for that. Man, that's going to be amazing. XFM. XFM, yes, that's exactly what you're listening to. This is Adam and Joe here on XFM. If you want to play Rock and Reel or Rock and Rubs, our fantastic new competition, give us a call right now. 0871 222 1049. Not only will you have the chance to win an amazing prize, you'll also get the chance to request any song you want from the X-List vaults. So call now, 0871 222 1049, and hopefully we'll play Rock and Reel or Rock and Rubs after this one from Pulp. That was Pulp with Babies.
Rock and Reel or Rock and Rubs. Are the bands real or are they just rubbish? Rock and Reel or Rock and Rubs. Are they real or are they rubs?
And we have Alison. No, it's not Alison. Who is it?
Heather.
Heather. Sorry, Heather. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thanks.
What are you up to this weekend?
I'm going to Leeds tomorrow, actually.
Going to Leeds?
Yes.
Wow. I've always wanted to go to Leeds. why are you going there?
It's my uncle's wedding.
Ah.
And I'm bridesmaid. It's quite exciting.
That's excellent.
Yes.
What are you going to wear?
A dress. is a general idea.
That's a... Well, I was thinking maybe no dress. What about that?
Really?
That would
well,
be... Cause,
perhaps not.
Because then he'd remember it forever.
Yeah, but for all the wrong reasons.
That's true.
Do you still find weddings exciting?
Not really, no.
No. Do you think... Isn't that the secret shame of Britain, that weddings are really boring?
Oh, come
they
on.
They are boring. Although we do have a bouncy castle.
Not if it's a relative, actually. If it's someone close that you care about, then they're brilliant.
It's always fun, you know, meet new people. Are you in a relationship, Heather, or do you think you might get drunk and snog someone tomorrow?
I'm thinking the drunk option would be good.
Really? Nice. That's bridesmaids, man. You're completely in the running for
you
some
really
action.
Are, cause you're,
I know, I thought that.
You know, I'm going to head down. Me and Adam are going to head down like Vince Vaughn and Owen Wilson.
We're going to
and
leave.
Crash the wedding.
Yeah.
And we're going to snog you.
That's
I'll
right.
snog you at about 7:35. Adam will get in there when you're a bit more drunk. You have to be a bit
I might
more
go
drunk.
A bit further.
At about 9.
I look forward to it.
Okay.
Heather, are you ready to play Rock and Reel or Rock and Rubs?
Yes.
Now, you know what to do, right?
Not really, actually.
Okay. I'm just going to read out 10 band names
okay.
as if I was reading the shipping forecast.
Mm-hmm.
And after each band name I say, you have to say either Reel or Rubs. Depending on whether you think it's a real band name from the NME gig section or one that I've just made up. Is that clear?
Okay, yes, that's clear.
Okay, cool. Let's play. And if you get over 7 correct, then you win a big prize as well as being able to, whatever happens, you'll be able to request a song, okay? So
excellent.
This is going to be amazing. Rock and Reel or Rock and Rubs? Heather. Number 1, P for Pancetta.
Reel.
Number 2, Ground in Dirt.
Rub.
Number 3, The Weather Underground.
Rub.
Number 4, Reese's Pieces.
Reel.
Number 5, Squibs.
Reel.
Number 6, The Rock of Travolta.
Reel.
Number 7, Hips Like Cinderella.
Real.
Number 8, The Clamps.
Real.
Number 9, Exhumed to the Slaughter.
Rub.
Number 10, Fickle Public.
Rub.
And Heather, that's it. I can tell you that you scored quite badly.
Oh dear.
Oh no.
You only got 4 correct.
Oh no.
P for Pancetta. You thought that was a real band. They should be, but it's not.
Oh.
Ground in Dirt, you correctly identified that as rubbish.
Yeah.
The Weather Underground, you thought that was made up. They're real.
Oh,
Reese's Pieces, they're real. Yeah. Squibs, you thought they were real. That's rubs. But it's only a matter of time, surely,
yeah.
before you get a band called Squibs.
Yeah. I'm obviously predicting the future.
Exactly. The Rock of Travolta, they're real. Hips Like Cinderella, that's a line from a Pixies song. That's a common tactic. I think there's about 5 bands with named after lines from Pixies
yeah.
songs.
6.
That's real. The Clamps, you thought that was real. That's rubbish. Exhumed to the Slaughter, you thought that was rubbish. That's real. Fickle Public, also real. So congratulations, Heather.
Hey, Heather, what do you do for a living?
I'm a student.
You're a student.
Yeah.
You're not a student of band names, though, are you?
No, I'm not.
Because you could spin that either way, really. Either you're hopelessly out of touch,
well,
or you're just brilliantly prescient.
Yeah, exactly. You're hopeful, and you've got a vivid imagination.
Yeah, exactly.
Optimistic.
I think we should give you a prize anyway. Are you a fan of very, very dark comedy?
Yes, I am.
Do you like Nighty Night?
Yes.
Would you want series 2 on DVD?
That would be brilliant.
Oh, there we go. I mean, you could have something else if you wanted.
Well, I'll tell you what you can have is a request as well. What would you like to request?
Oh, I'd love to hear Richard III by Seafgrass.
We have it for you. Heather, have a fantastic time tomorrow. Can't wait to give you a big snog.
Thanks for calling, Heather. Yes, so 7:35, I'll see you around the back of the stripy tent.
Okay.
I'll be by the bar at around 9.
I'll be the one in the dress.
Okay, okay. Fantastic. Here's Richard III. There you go. That's one of the all-time best songs by one of the all-time best bands in the world, in my humble opinion, Supergrass, with Richard III going out to Heather. You know, Supergrass are one of these bands who release promos for their new albums on CD formats that won't play in your computer. And so that just renders them unlistenable, as far as I'm concerned, because I haven't got a CD player hooked up to my stereo at the moment. I just play everything through my computer. So I just didn't listen to their last album. Do you know what I mean?
Because you can't burn it off.
No, well, because I can't import it into iTunes and listen to it when I want. So what's that? What's that? That's rubbish.
They're stymieing themselves.
It's useless. I just think, surely, they can't be increasing their sales that way. There's so many bands that do that, and you just think, ooh, I'm excited to listen to this.
I thought that went out of fashion, doing that. Because there was a phase when everyone did that, didn't they? Non-copyable CDs.
Yeah.
But then they stopped. Because the fans were getting angry.
Well, sometimes what happens is you can import the first four tracks or something, and then it becomes impossible to read. But I just think that's self-defeating, you know? Because I don't know how the last Supergrass album sold, but I don't think it was a complete smash. And it probably should have been, because they're always amazing.
Come on, Supergrass, make your records copyable.
Get with the kids.
Get with the kids.
You know?
Lily Allen. Pirating music is... what's the opposite? I'm not talking of about destroying pirating. The industry?
No, listen, man, I'm not talking about pirating. I wasn't going to...
It's revivifying the industry.
I wasn't going to distribute it. I just wanted to listen to it. It's nothing to do with pirating.
Music piracy is creating
Why
music.
Are you, stop going on about piracy. Sorry. I just wanted to hear the thing.
Well, importing
it to
iTunes, it's a hazy line, isn't it?
Well, no, it's not. It's just iTunes is just a way of listening to music. You know what I mean?
But I agree with you. I think being able to copy music is actually important, because you can put it onto CDs, make it into compilations and play it to your friends. And that's how most people hear new music, you know?
I read somewhere that cassettes are coming back.
Really?
Yeah, that they're supposed to be the new groovy format.
What?
To make compilations on.
Really?
Yeah. Because there's something nice about being locked into someone else's compilation
Not
choice.
Being able to skip.
Yeah, I mean, obviously you can fast forward and rewind and stuff, but it's nice just to not be... Yeah, you can't just
how
jump
that,
about.
How will we see that happening? Chunky Walkman's coming into fashion.
Possibly.
On the belt.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah?
Possibly. Because you can barely buy a decent tape player anymore. They phase so many formats out. Like, they're phasing... I tried to buy a DAT recorder the other day to listen to some of our previous shows for our podcasts. Can't buy DAT players anymore. You know?
What's the world coming to?
What is the world coming to when they just phase out the format so quickly? It's rip-off Britain.
Rip-off Britain.
That's what it is. You know, they just want you to invest in the next rip-off format.
Arrgh.
I can't deal with it. It's blowing
Play
my mind.
Play some angry music.
Right, here's the Eagles of Death Metal.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Fantastic. That's the Eagles of Death Metal from their first album, which is called Peace, Love and Death Metal, or just Peace, Love, Death Metal. And that's called... I Only Want You. It's Adam and Joe here on XFM.
Do they do different flavoured Jaffa Cakes?
Yeah, they do. They do.
Do you get strawberry ones?
Not that I know of. It's lime and...
Lime?
Raspberry.
Lime and raspberry.
Mm.
Why not strawberry ones?
I know.
Why not coffee flavoured ones?
What? You just have like a...
Coffee jelly.
Coffee jelly.
Oh, tasty coffee jelly.
Coffee jelly.
What about... Yeah. What? What about another flavour that I can't think of?
What about bubblegum?
What about, what's that jelly you get in Spanish tapas bars? You know? Like
no.
That sort of savoury orange...
Aspic.
Yeah. What about aspic?
Aspic Jaffa cakes.
You could put anything in there. Couldn't you?
Yeah. What about you could have Bongella Jaffa cakes?
Mmm. Sort out your... you know, ulcers, whilst giving you a tasty, sporty snack.
Bongella cakes.
Yeah.
That's a good idea,
That's
though.
A very good idea. You know, I had a very good idea this week. I'm the man who thought up the Thrix, the three-stick twix.
I forgot.
As the man who thought up the Thrix,
yeah.
And I stress, listeners, that is copyrighted and patent pending.
Mm-hmm.
I've also thought of a very good idea for water delivery. This is something we might go into another week, but Adam bought a very stylish bottle of water this week that came in a kind of plastic colostomy bag.
It's called the platypus, and it's a little fold-up thing. It folds up to the size of something you could just easily put in your pocket, but
once you've drunk all the water, you can then expel it into the same packet.
But once it's full of water, the force of the water opens the thing out. You can get about a litre of water in there, and it just stands up of its own accord.
Extraordinary.
It's only about a quid, this thing. You can get them from camping shops.
Platypus.
Yeah.
Yeah. But so that's a new innovative way to deliver water. Why do Evian or a bottled water company not make Evian water pistols?
Mm.
So it's a litre of water, half a litre of water, with a cheap water pistol mechanism on it.
That is genius.
The kids would go mad for it.
Genius.
Strap it on your belt, squirt it into your mouth, squirt it at other people in the street.
Mm.
Right, my name's Joe Cornish. That is patented, right, and copyright. If anyone does that, I get all the profits.
Surely somebody listening to the show knows somebody's uncle who once
works at water bottling design companies.
Get in touch, will you, you
and
lunatics.
I tell you the other thing, I've thought about this in detail, because obviously in this current climate, you don't want people going around with fake guns.
Nobody
so
wants
So you
that.
Make it like a space gun.
Yeah.
Like Bobbly. You know,
absolutely.
Like a what's the bit, the sticky out bit on a gun? The barrel made of like blobs, four circular like things.
Well,
so
you could
it looks
retain
like a space ray gun.
The main barrel of the thing could retain the essential design elements of the bottle. You know,
yes.
The ridged barrel.
Yes.
And it could compress as well, because you know those bottles are designed to compress.
Yes, to fold up in the bin.
Once
to squash.
Yeah, so you can recycle them.
In fact, why don't all soft drinks get delivered like that? Then when you walk into a newsagent, it's like a kind of cool armory.
Mm-hmm.
And you could get, I'll have a Gatling gun of Coke. You know, I'll have a bazooka. I'll have a Tizer bazooka.
Mm-hmm.
And you could fire big blobs of Tizer at high speed into your mate's mouth. It'd be brilliant.
And you could do the same for booze as well. That would revolutionise the game of Beer Hunter.
Yes. Why aren't we in charge of everything?
I don't know.
We are wasted stupid radio station.
We're completely wasted. Before we go, we've got another lovely classic song to end our show here on XFM. But before that, we should mention as well, don't forget to download our podcast. The podcast was late this week. It should have come out yesterday, but it didn't, because we were recording some new stuff for it and I failed to get it edited in time. But I hope it's going to come out on Monday, and then there'll be another new one on
Friday.
I've
discovered something about the iTunes chart. Apparently, it's solely on new subscriptions.
Oh, is it?
It's not on downloads at all. The podcast chart relies purely on new subscriptions.
Right.
So if you hear the Adam and Joe podcast and like it, please tell a friend and get them to subscribe. They don't even have to listen to it.
No.
All they have to do is click subscribe.
I told you the other day I had a big argument with my brother because he wouldn't subscribe. He said, I can listen to it on the
website. He's a traitor.
Website. He's a total traitor.
He's a traitor.
So what? It's not going to hurt you if you just click subscribe. It doesn't charge you anything. All it does is flop into your inbox every week. That's all. You don't have to do anything.
It's worth his while, because if you make more money, and then you might leave some to him in your will.
Mm.
If you pop your clogs, he'll be in the money.
Exactly.
Ka-ching.
You know, if I...
What
if
more motivation?
If we get famous, I could buy him a big scooter.
Yeah.
And that's the thing that he's not taking into account. Because we don't get paid for the podcasts. It's not a big money-changing operation. We're just trying to spread
it's
the
charity.
Word. It's charity.
Anyway.
Chuckle charity.
Yeah, there you go. So you can find the podcast at www.xfm.co.uk or on the iTunes podcast thing.
So get downloading. Also, a couple of TV recommendations this week. I am currently contributing little bits to Amanda Iannucci's new series, Time Trumpet. Number 3 goes out this week on Thursday at 10 o'clock on BBC Two. Check that out. Lots of funny stuff in there. And right after that is Charlie Brooker's excellent series, Screen Wipe, on BBC Four, to which I contributed to very briefly last week. But that's it for my contribution.
So it's
safe to watch now. It's also got the best theme tune of any TV show at the moment. I think, check this out, see what you think. Nice.
Yeah, that's good.
Charlie Brooker's Screen Wipe, BBC Four, Thursday nights at 10:30, and of course Amanda Iannucci's Time Trumpet on BBC Two at 10 p.m. on Thursday nights. Now, this is the last song of our show and the last song of the X List this week. This is dedicated to, is this Johnny or Tommy? Johnny in Essex.
Johnny.
This one's for you. Lou Reed with Walk on the Wild Side. Thanks for listening.